Hey, what's up, guys? Izzy or Sick Izzy here, and I haven't done a video in quite a while, and I'm so sorry about that. I really haven't had time, and when I do have time, I usually put it into like doing some other stuff that you know. And I'm just really sorry about that, but I am gonna try and you know, come back and just redo a lot of tutorials that I've kind of messed up on, and you know, just do my best, I guess. But this is something that I've been wanting to do for quite a while, and I haven't really, like I said, had the time for it. And I also didn't know if you guys would like if I did this or not. So, basically, the approach I have here is that I will attempt to like give you a final image, and I'm gonna show you a whole bunch of techniques that I do, you know, in between. I'll show you a lot of techniques. And you know, just stuff like that. And it's actually an alternate way of learning, and it's more how do I say? I guess easier. I'm not sure if it would be easier for you to learn, but it's better. I guess I'm saying it's better than just doing individual tutorials. So I guess you'll get like five tutorials out of this video, hopefully. And I'm gonna try to make these as short as possible, maybe around 10 to 15 minutes. So. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do in this video, huh? Oh, this is the original, and what I'm gonna be attempting to do is using lighting effects from Photoshop and to create something like this. And see, as we can tell in this image, we have like a kind of a focus right here, and this is where our kind of our eye draw to this place right here, and all this other stuff is just like little details. And as we can tell, this is taken in a studio with you know, full lighting, but we want to kind of give it a little bit more dramatic feel and kind of, you know, make it so our eyes just go right here, like kind of enhance that. I don't really know what I'm saying here, but you know, just kind of what I wanted to do with this image. So go ahead and delete this. First of all, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add a curves adjustment. And actually, before I add a curves adjustment, I'm gonna get my lasso tool or my elliptical marquee tool, and I'm just gonna make a little selection around here because this is where we want our eyes to be focused on. It's where we're gonna want a lot of the lighting. Now, if you're using CS5 and you know anything below CS6. You want to feather this to about maybe 50 pixels. You want to just kind of vary that out, or you can also go to refine edge if you want. But since I'm using CS6, we have this in the properties, and it's just a lot easier. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a curves adjustment. Actually, before I do that, I'm gonna select the inverse. So I'm gonna go select inverse, and I'm gonna go ahead and create a curves adjustment. And what this does is everything that was selected will be darkened or lightened except the middle spot. So because it kind of gave it a layer mask out of that selection. So what we're gonna do here is actually just darken it up a little bit. And I'm just gonna bring this down like so. And as you can tell, the curve goes all the way down and it eventually stops like around here, but well, it looks that it's like it stops around here because it has to make a curve, you know what I mean? So I'm just gonna make another point here and I'm just gonna bring that back up because we do want kind of a straight line there, and you'll see what I mean. But yeah, something like this. And since like I said, we have this in the properties, so all you have to do is just select your layer mask and go ahead and feather this out. I'm gonna feather it to about, yeah, 50 pixels looks nice, maybe 60. Right, something like that. And you can see we have something like this. And I think it's a little bit too dark, maybe. So I'm just gonna go ahead and bring this opacity down to 50. Actually, bring that up a little bit. Yeah, 80 looks nice. All right. We tend to overdo things sometimes, so you know. So I'm gonna add another curves adjustment, and for this one, I just wanna bring out some of those highlights. I mean, you can see them, but since we use this, it kind of took that away. Since we use these curves down here, we kind of just took that away. So I'm gonna bring them back up, and I'm actually gonna try to attempt to bring some back up, and you know, where we're trying to focus at. So I'm gonna just darken this up a little bit. It's just gonna be the overall image. We don't need no layer. We don't need any layer mask. I'm sorry for my English, and just bring that in like that, and then we're gonna go ahead and just pop this up a little bit, just like so. We don't want to overdo it again. So we have until we have something nice. Something like that. You can already see what it's done to the image. And I'll probably reduce the opacity on this to about maybe 80%. How about 75%? All right, cool. We have something like that. All right, now I'm gonna create a new layer, and I'm just gonna go to Image, Apply Image, and click OK on this. And now for this, the reason we did this is because now we're gonna be messing with the lightings, and we don't want to mess with the lighting filter on our original image. So we went on and applied it. But again, if you need to change anything, all you would have to do is just go ahead and delete this layer, the one that where we applied it, and go back and mess with your curves and then reapply the image. All right, sorry for the inconvenience. I had a little bit of difficulty here. But anyways, so you want to go to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects right here. And now, as you can see, I already have the light set up, so I'm just gonna go ahead and delete them and restart for you guys. And I'm gonna show you the whole process of doing this. This is actually a really powerful tool, and I know CS5 comes with it. I'm not sure if CS4 does, but yeah, you should really try this out. I've never used or ever really tried this out, but it's really good. So basically, you want to add a light, and I'm gonna show you kind of the concept of this whole diagram we have here. Basically, we're here. You bring up the intensity. You can also do this over here. So you have a little slider over here if you want to do that. And this will be the overall where the light shines and how it's being put on the image. And this here is called your hotspot, which is basically where you want the light to hit the most. So I really wish we could move this around, and but sadly we can't. So we have to like adjust. And the only way we could actually move it is by just clicking here and just moving it around. And like so, but I really wish we could just move the hotspot, but we can't, so it's fine, we'll just adjust to it. Anyways, so here I'm using a spotlight, and the spotlight, of course, it has a hotspot, so I'm gonna go ahead and scale this around, and I think I already like it the way I had it, but you know what, it's fine. Just gonna put it like this. And we can kind of see what that does. And now I want to bring up the intensity just a little bit, not too much, because we're going to be adding another light. So we have something like that. And the hotspot, I think I want to just a little bit smaller, maybe. Something like this. I'm going to change the angle because I see that in this corner it's a little bit too dark, and it gets too dark a little bit quick. So I'm just going to widen this up a little bit. Maybe scale it. I'll just probably move it too. So just gonna do this, and now with the sliders, like I said, it's much easier if you just scale the hotspot with the slider. So you can bring it down like that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it like that, and bring that like that. All right, so now I'm gonna add another light. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go over here. Just gonna add another light and another spotlight, I'm gonna say. And now this one's the default one, so they usually just look like this. So you just wanna I'm gonna scale this up again, maybe around like this. And I'm gonna scale the length as well. But this one I don't want as bright. I still want it bright, but not as bright, because like I said, we want to focus over here, not over here. So this is just to kind of fill that in, you know what I mean? Just give us a little bit more to look at over here, and not have it so dark. So do something like that. And now I'm just gonna bring down the intensity by a bunch. So have something like this, and maybe scale this up. To have something like that. That's actually pretty nice. And yeah, so you can also colorize it if you wish, but I don't really wish to do that now. So here are your lights, and these are this is your spotlight 2.0 or 2.0 or whatever. And this is your spotlight 2, I guess. So you can actually just go back and edit them if you feel like you messed up or something. So I'm just gonna go back to the first one and kind of change the angle up and maybe bring that intensity down a little bit. And now I'm gonna add this one, another light, and I don't really know what this one's called. It's called an infinite light, and I'm pretty sure that the CS5.5 has this, but I just never messed around with it. So this infinite light actually goes around the whole image. So like if I bring this up like this, the light will be coming straight towards it, and if I just move it down like this, then you can see how it kind of darkens it up a bit. And that's what we kind of want to do. So we want to lighten it up, but we don't want to lighten it up too much. So we're just going to change the angle and just, do something like this. And I really don't know. I'm pretty sure you can move this, but I don't remember how. Again, it's just really mostly trial and error. So, just mess around with it. You can grab this little kind of sphere right here and just move it around. And again, this is the intensity, so we're just gonna bring the intensity down a little bit. All right, so we have something like this. I feel it's a little bit too much on our face, so I'm gonna go back to the first spotlight and I'm just gonna bring this down a little bit. Because we don't want any like anything to be too bright on our face, because that loses detail and then it looks ugly. So we have something like this, and that looks nice, so we're just gonna click OK. And now Photoshop does its job, and we have something like this. See, that looks a lot more dramatic, and just looks really great overall. So now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna add another curves adjustment. This is just gonna be a little bit of editing, I guess, color editing. So I'm gonna go into the greens, and I want to kind of, like I said, make this a little bit more dramatic. So I'm gonna bring this up. So I'm just gonna pop this up just a little bit. See, if we pop it up in the middle, that'll pop up our midtones. We pop it over here, that'll pop up our darks, and this is gonna be our light. So we want to kind of get the middle between midtones and light. So we're just gonna click right here, kind of just bring that up just a tad bit. And then I'm gonna click down here because I don't want the shadows to be green as well. So I just wanna bring that down just a bit. Not too much, because if you do it, if you overdo it, it'll look purple. So just something like that. Now I'm gonna go to the blues because I do want the shadows to be a little bit blue. So I'm gonna get the bottom point, and I'm just gonna bring that up just a bit, like so. And I'm actually gonna select in the middle and just bring that down a little bit, because I still want to be able to see that green in there. So just bring that down. But you can see that the shadows are actually blue, or a shade of blue. So that's our final image, guys. And I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this kind of step-by-step thing that I do. If you guys like it, please feel free to let me know in the comments below, and I guess drop a like or whatever. I'm not trying to force you to do anything, but thanks for watching, guys, and as always, I'll see you next time. But I guess. All right, guys, bye-bye.